الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him. We seek help from Him. We ask forgiveness from Him. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. I bear witness that there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without any partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the series of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, we're still with the ethics of al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the first part of the khutbah, inshallah, we're going to address the accepted istighfar that conditioned with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So always, whenever you do something, so ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make what you do is for the sake of face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To stay away from any showing off and stay away from any thing that your goal, your ultimate goal is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in Surah Al-Baqarah verse 284, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبَكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهُ فَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. For all what's in the heaven and earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sole controller and sole owner of everything in the heavens and the earth. And whatever within yourselves or whatever you can show or whatever you hide, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to hold you accountable for. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive for whoever He wants and who going to punish whoever He wants. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most powerful and He is the most able of all affairs. Also, in another verse, in Surah Al Imran 129, وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ يَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Similar to the previous verse in Ayat Surah Al Baqarah, وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sole controller of all what's in heaven and what's in earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive whoever He wants and will punish whoever He wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Ghafoor and Rahim, the most merciful and the most forgiving. Now, in verse 18 in Surah Al-Ma'idah, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحِبَّاؤُهُ قُلْ فَلِمَ يُعَذِّبُكُمْ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ بَلْ أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ مِمَّنْ خَلَقَ يَغْفُرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرِ. So the Yahud and Nasara said, we are the most beloved sons of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are His beloved sons, and we are His, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So said Prophet Muhammad, so why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you with your sins? But you are from the creations and from the whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create, from the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive to whoever He wants, and He will punish whoever he wants. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs to him all what's in the heaven and the earth and whatever in between too. And everything will be returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sole control of every affairs in this, in the all heavens and all earth and in between them. In another verse, Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 40, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَغْفُرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Indeed, don't you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the kingdom of the heavens and the kingdoms of the earth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the control of all what's in the heaven and what's in the earth, everything under his control. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish whoever he wants, and he will forgive whoever he wants. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most able of all affairs. And look at this conversation between Sayyidina Isa and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment. Look at this, which is in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 116 to 118. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ أَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخَذُونِي وَأُمِّي إِلَهَيْنِ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ مَا يَكُونَ لِي أَنْ أَقُولَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِحَقٍّ إِنْ كُنْتُ قُلْتُهُ فَقَدْ عَلِمْتُهُ تَعْلَمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِي وَلَا أَعْلَمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِكَ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Anta, you told to the people, take me and my mother as gods, as switches to Allah, without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Isa would respond, praise to you, Allah, I cannot say to what I don't have right to. I did not say to them whatever I said, you knew. If I said it, you knew it. And you know what's within me, within myself. And I don't know what's within you. You are the most, the most knowledgeable about all the unseen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. This is how polite Prophet Isa alayhi salam when he spoke back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا قُلْتُ لَهُمْ إِلَّا مَا أَمَرْتَنِي بِهِ أَنْ أَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبَّكُمْ وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهُمْ فَلَمَّا تَوَفَّيْتَنِي كُنْتُ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. I did not say to them except what you ordered me to say. Worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. And I was witness with them while I was alive with them. But when you raised me, you are the one who knows about them, and you are witness on them. إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. If you punish them, they are your slave, and if you forgive them, you are the most exalted and the most wise. See how polite Prophet Isa in response to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that. Also, in another verse, Surah Al-Ahzab, the parties, verse 21-42, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرَجُ اللَّهُ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهِ كَثِيرًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that take the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a role model, a good model that you should follow. Whatever he say, whatever he is doing, that you should follow. Whoever he wants to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with the day of judgment, and whoever will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. And what? ولما راى المؤمنون الاحزاب قالوا هذا ما وعدنا الله ورسوله وصدق الله ورسوله وما زادهم الا ايمانا وتسليما. And when the believers saw the parties in the expedition of the parties, they said, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Prophet promised us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most trustworthy and the most truthful. And the Prophet too. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. The companions with the Prophet Muhammad, they believed strongly in him. So whatever the Prophet said, and Allah, he knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most trusted and the most truthful, and the Prophet too. And they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strongly. مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَهَدُوا اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. From the believers, people that they believed what they promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some of them they already passed away, and some of them they waiting and they did not change. So the believers, they don't change what they received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet, they don't change, they stick to it. They don't deviate, they don't go right and left, to straight to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and what the Prophet said. ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب المنافقين إن شاء أو يتوب عليهم إن الله كان غفورا رحيما. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's going to reward the trusted, the truthful people, the believers, because of their truthfulness. And he's going to punish the hypocrites if he wants. This means that it's up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to punish or to forgive or to punish. أو يتوب. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repent, had repentance with him, in them. إن الله كان غفورا رحيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful and the most forgiving. Also in Surah Al-Fath, verse 14, ولله ملك السماوات والأرض يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء وكان الله غفورا رحيما. Again, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the heaven and earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive whomever he wants, and he will punish whomever he wants. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And look, after all this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful and the most forgiving. So أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله عسى أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. The acceptance of الاستغفار, it is for the believers and for the people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 9, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ مَغْفَرَةً وَأَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the believers and the believers who did the good deeds, all the deeds are good, for them forgiveness and great rewards. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say ajrun azim, this is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say azim, this means it's a great reward according to the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a greatness that we cannot comprehend. It's a greatness that we cannot put boundaries to that greatness. So whenever, and maghfira, this means that if you be believers and do right things and leave the rest for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you great. So that's the great thing. That's the thing that you should just also always work for. That ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that all the time. And in another verse, Surah Muhammad, verse 15, مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وَعَدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسن وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات، ومغفرة من ربهم كمن هو خالد في النار وسقوا ماء حميم فقطع معاهم. Look at this. The Allah سبحانه وتعالى is telling about the paradise that Allah سبحانه وتعالى promised the believers. He promised the pious, the people who fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Within this paradise, rivers of good water, rivers that this water is not, it's just the perfect water to drink. Also rivers of milk that his, its taste will never change. And also other rivers from wine that has the most delicious taste. The wine of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the river is different than the wine in this earth. The wine is that would be the most delicious, the most for the people who drink it, and it's completely different than the wine that known in this earth here. Also, and also rivers, other rivers of pure honey. Oh, look at this. Rivers of great water, and river of great milk, that will never, its taste will never change. After the, if you leave the milk here a few days, it's going to not, the taste will change. And no, the milk of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala will never change, and the rivers of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala in the of the wine that will have the great taste. And also other rivers of pure honey. All these rivers will be underneath you, underneath the in the heavens for you. So you can, it will be plenty that you will, nothing will finish, nothing will end. It will be all for you because of you believe in Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and for the whoever will have will fear Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. All this for Allah for them. For Allah Subhanahu wa Taala promised, and المتقون, the people who fear Him, all these rivers are going to be for them. ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات, and all the fruits that you think of, is going to be there. Also, fruits that will never go rotten, fruits will stay always fresh. That's there for you because of rewards. ومغفرة من ربه, and the most important thing, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala will forgive all your sins when you are with Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. All your sins will be forgiven. All this, compare all what I mentioned now to whoever going to stay in the hellfire forever. The people who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people who don't believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're going to stay in the hellfire forever. And what you're going to drink, they're going to drink that water going to cut their stomach from its hot, going to be very hot, and it will be very bad that even when they drink, they cannot even bear it, because their stomach, their inner parts are going to be turned apart, because it's going to be just punishment all the time. Compare that, put this to the one side and put on the other side. So go to the side where that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised for the best, for the most good that you're going to have in the afterlife, comparing to the people who disbelieve in Allah and you don't believe in the oneness of Allah, they're going to be punished in the hellfire. Also, in another verse in Surah Fath 1 and 2, Inna fatahna laka fathan mubina. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet Muhammad. Inna fatahna laka fathan mubina. Liyaghfira laka Allahu ma taqaddama min dhanbik wa ma ta'akhkhar. ويتم نعمته عليك ويهديك صراطا مستقيما. Most beautiful, most beautiful. إن فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا. الله سبحانه وتعالى, we open for you a great opening. That is, ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى will forgive for your previous sins and for whatever after. ويتم نعمته, and all Allah سبحانه وتعالى will complete His blessings on you. ويهديك صراطا مستقيما, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you to the best path. So see what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did in his life, and we knew that he didn't make any sins, but still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive his previous sins and his coming sins, and he had a great opening. That was in Hudaybiyah, Ghazwat al-Hudaybiyah, when some of the companions thought that this is something bad happened to them, But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet, from the Prophet, this is a great opening. And this is what exactly what happened. All the conditions that the disbelievers themselves put on the Prophet, they thought it is for them, but in reality it was against them. It was in the great favor of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that was the great opening, that from that moment on, Islam was rising. Islam was rising because from that moment on, Islam spread. From that moment, Hudaybiyah, Islam was recognized as a powerful force in Arabia, and the people start to come to believe. And even some of the disbelievers themselves start to come to the Prophet and announce their Islam, like Khalid ibn Walid or Amr ibn al-As and others. So this was a great opening for the rising of Islam from that moment and on. Also in Surah Al-Fath, verse 29, look at this. Muhammad Rasulullah, والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحم بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود ذلك مثلهم في التوراة ومثلهم في الإنجيل كزرع أخرجته فآزره فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع ليغيظ بهم الكفار وعد الله الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات منهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. Always. When you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet, and you follow the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet, expect and pray for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing that for Muhammad Rasulullah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, never address him in his name. He addressed him always, Ya Ayyuhan Nabiyyu, Ya Ayyuhan Rasul. But here is talking about Muhammad Rasulullah, he did not address him. But he just stated that the Muhammad, the Prophet of Allah, and the people with him, they are strong on the disbelievers, and they are merciful among themselves. You always see them prostrating, making ruku', and they always seeking blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In their face, you see it. You see the blessing. You see the light. In their face, and this is because of their making sujood. But this is going to be also in the day of judgment, when the believers who make their sujood, their face going to be recognized because of their sujood. Their face going to be has lights on it, and from making wudu and making sujood, The believers are going to be distinguished. They are not going to be like everybody else. In the Torah and Injil, these were examples of like a plant, and that plant is fruited and has the fruits, and the people will look at it with admiration. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the believers, whoever make good deeds, maghfaratan wa ajran azeema. Again, maghfara, forgiveness, and a great, great reward. In another verse in Surah Al-Hajjat 2 and 4, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتُكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون إن الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم التقوى لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم. The most important thing, when you follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you that was for the companion of the Prophet, when you ask him, because at the time when the believer, the companion, was talking around the Prophet, they was raising their voices. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala educated the companions how to treat the Prophet, to the extent after this verse, the companion used to whisper when they are around the Prophet, because we're afraid. Because you see, أَنْ تَحْبَطْ عَمَالَكُمْ, which means if you raise your voice on the Prophet, your good deeds is not going to get accepted. So the believers or the companions after that, they start being taken low. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala educated the companions how to treat the Prophet. And this is the reason that the people, whoever will meet the Prophet and the companion, they will see that he is like a, he's among them, it's like the king without the power of a kingdom or the kingship. They will rush to listen to him. They will rush to obey his orders. Just because of that's a gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet, because he has the mercy. He was merciful. They loved him. And the Prophet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet, if you are tough and rough, these people stay with you. They're going to stay away from you. But since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet that qualities, that he was merciful, and everybody loved him. Everybody wanted to stay near him, and everybody wanted to obey him. And this big difference between the way that the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam treated him, and the companions of Prophet Musa treated Prophet Musa. The companions of Prophet Musa, they give him hard time, all the time, challenging, giving him hard time. But the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam always was polite, and under his obedience to him in a way that because they knew that whatever the Prophet said, that's coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the companion of the Prophet because of that. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Because the people, before that, when the people was calling the Prophet before this verse, they was raising their voice, but after that, no more. So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala educated the companions how to treat the Prophet. And also to give them forgiveness and to give them ajr azim, always forgiveness and great reward. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته ويجعل لكم نورا تمشون به ويغفر لكم والله غفور رحيم. Again, the people who will become Muslims, they will get two rewards. If whatever they did good before that, they're going to be rewarded for it. It's not going to be wasted. And also will get reward after that too. So two rewards, يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته, from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ويغفر لكم والله غفور رحيم. Again, the forgiveness is the most important thing that we should keep in mind, that we need to stick to it. That's our goal, is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. This is always keep your tongue asking for forgiveness all the time. Astaghfirullah al-azim al-lazi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh. That we should have this day and night in our tongues. Also, we have two more verse 7, which is 16 and 17 for Surah Al-Taghabun. فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم واسمعوا وأطيعوا وأنفقوا خيرا لأنفسكم ومن يوق شح نفسه فأولئك هم المفلحون. إن تقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا يضاعفه لكم ويغفر لكم والله شكور حليم. Now about when you say إن تقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا, when you give Allah سبحانه وتعالى loan, how you give Allah سبحانه وتعالى loan, تقرض الله, when you do something charitable, when you give something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like you giving loans to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to multiply it for you. He's going to reward you abundantly when you do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you go to visit the sick person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there for you to receive your good deeds, and he will, in a divine hadith about that. When you do anything good and for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you expect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you with a great reward. So always that keep in mind. And وَيَغْفَرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ شَكُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. Plus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most thankful and for what you do. The last verse that we want to end with, Surah Al-Mulk, verse 12. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفَرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. Now, the people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil ghaib, they keep in their mind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. In the unseen and unseen, either when they are not seen or they are not seen, if they are by themselves or among the people, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has great reward for them and also forgiveness. Great forgiveness. Forgiveness is the most great thing that believers will receive from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and when they follow His path. أدعو الله أن نكون منهم يا الله. Oh Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart, and spirit. Oh Allah, do not let our hearts deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of creations. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي للصلاة حي للفلاة كاتب صلاة كاتب صلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله إلا الله
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر
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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا الله أكبر
الله أكبر
صلى الله عليه وسلم حمده
ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر
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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله استغفر الله